Hi, folks. Welcome to History Matters, and so does coffee. I don't have coffee, but I have a mug, so that counts for something. I am here. I am recording this as an honorary for Thanksgiving Day brief episode of History Matters, and so does coffee. Nobody is here right now to tell me, but I believe this is the 191st straight episode, and none of you are here to tell me that I'm wrong. So I'm going to pretend like it's the 191st straight episode, which is kind of mind-blowing. So I just wanted to briefly offer you something that I found when I was digging around trying to figure out what to give you for Thanksgiving this year. I wanted to find spiffy quotes. I thought, maybe some spiffy founder quotes, or I don't know what I thought. I think one year I went looking, one year I read, I think, William Seward's original Thanksgiving Day announcement, which Lincoln delivered, but Seward wrote. I think one day I talked about like Thanksgiving days in the past. At any rate, I have something totally different this year, and it's very pegged to where we are right now. And it's actually from 1896. So I did go digging in honor of the History Matters community. And I first went to Google Books and was searching around, Thanksgiving history, Thanksgiving quotes. And then I realized, oh no, Joanne, limited to books in the 19th century and see what happens. Now, Thanksgiving Day became officially Thanksgiving Day, not necessarily in every state, but it was celebrated in something akin to the way we know it beginning in the mid 19th century. So that's where I went. Here I am recreating my research process for you. So that's where I went, and I came up with lots of things. I almost was going to read you a children's story called, I think it was something like Mischief's Thanksgiving, but it really just wasn't good enough to read to you. But it had a lot of reprinting, so clearly it was very popular. But at any rate, what I ultimately found was, let me get the title here, it's the Proceedings of a Thanksgiving Day Banquet of the American Society in London. Okay, so these are Americans in London in 1896. And they are celebrating Thanksgiving. Now, this is in the tradition of a lot of these kind of pamphlets that would come out in the 19th century that would just, the toasts would be recorded, the speeches would be recorded, a description of the fancy, amazing decorations in the hall would be recorded. And it would be kind of like a commemorative, look how great we are kind of pamphlet. So, this is one of those pamphlets. But in the section on toasts, there was a toast that is kind of remarkable that it was in 1896, but I want to offer it to you. It was a person trying to figure out what to toast. It actually was a woman, and I'm not going to read the part in which she says something along the lines of, oh, women, do they have political opinions anyway? Because feh to that. But she does say towards the end of that toast, I don't know what being a Republican is. Unless it is to belong to a party whose motto, as nearly as I can find out, seems to be, quote, success at any price payable in gold. And I need not be a Democrat either, though I am likewise ignorant of what a Democrat is, unless it is that he is a member of a party which seems to have been created by a beneficent providence for the express purpose, judging by recent events, of securing an overwhelming Republican majority. The way the Democratic Party runs away from itself is like the description the famous old bear hunter gave of a pair of deerskin trousers he made for himself. When he finished them, one was bow-legged and the other knock-kneed, and he said, I give you my word of honor that when I wore those trousers, I looked as if I was chasing myself off the face of the earth. Okay. The motto of the Republican Party, according to this person in 1896, is, success at any price payable in gold. And the Democrats, according to this person in 1896, are the party dedicated to running away from themselves and giving power somehow to the Republicans. 1896, right? That's how fascinating is that? So that is my gift to you for this Thanksgiving on a slightly more serious level. I do want to offer a few words about what I'm thankful for. I am thankful that we have been doing this for, I believe, now 191 weeks. I am thankful to the National Council for History Education for hosting this for that time, for being the platform where History Matters can meet and be. I'm thankful for being a historian. I'm thankful for teaching history. I'm thankful for joining up every week with you, this particular group of people, to talk about history, to talk about politics, and most of all, to talk about democracy, the conversation of democracy that we have every Friday morning, which, as I say, ever and eternally, means a lot. But more than anything else, I'm thankful to the History Matters community, which is a mind-blowingly wonderful community. Who knew that when I started this thing that it was going to build into something that lasted as long as it has lasted, does the kind of work that it does? Because as much as we enjoy being together here, we're interrogating important things together every week and creating a forum where you can ask questions and we can figure out the answers. And it's just a wonderful community. I am not on Slack because I have not fully decided what it is or how I should use it. However, what I want to say on Thanksgiving is how thankful I am to all of you. Before I show the mug, so I'm imagining on the bottom of the screen is mug, mug, mug. I'm wearing a shirt expressly as a tribute to our community. In this case, it's a t-shirt. It's a Pomona College t-shirt that Emily Borowski gave me a little while back. I'm gonna do something very uncouth. It's a Pomona College t-shirt, which I love to wear. And I saw it hanging out here waiting to be worn and thought that's a nice way to say something about how much I appreciate the community because I do. I appreciate NCHE and I very, very, very much appreciate the History Matters and So Does Coffee community. I'm wishing all of you watching this and even those not watching this a wonderful holiday, however you choose to celebrate it or not to celebrate it, with friends, with family, by yourself. I'm really good at really extravagant solo Thanksgivings. So I do not necessarily feel sorry for solo Thanksgivings. They can be a fine and wonderful thing. Newbie and I had a few together. But at any rate, whatever you're doing or not doing on Thanksgiving, I wish you all happiness. I wish us all safety and peace in the coming year and the rest of this year too. I wish us all good things and I wish us to continue on as a community with the bonds of togetherness and the bonds of knowledge that bring us together here every week. So happy Thanksgiving, everybody. I will see you next week where we will continue the conversation from last week about our heated political times. There were so many questions that we didn't get them all answered. I was talking about the congressional violence and uproar and threats, and then we were stepping back and talking a little bit more broadly about political rhetoric and threats generally and the political climate. And I'm not going to talk about that anymore Thanksgiving week, but we will in a week's time. So, everybody, really have a wonderful holiday, and I will see you guys in a week.